Here we're going to cover our disc, our CD, DVD operation, and our iPod operation real quickly. Once we input or insert a CD, we're going to get our loading screen, and on a standard CD, there's not going to be much to this screen. It's really going to be fairly basic. You know, once the disc goes in, it'll start playing, and will give you track and time display along with all your fast forward, track up, track down, etc. controls. And the one thing that is kind of nice about this that's fairly unique is on the track list button, you also have direct access to any other track on the disc. So, for instance, if you want to go to track 14, you're at track 14. And instead of having to hit seek up or down a number of times, you can have direct access to that track directly from that menu. You've got repeat and random play as well on CD, so that's kind of nice. And then eject is out here as a hard button, blinks at you, and then it'll hand you your disc back. Now, if we want to watch a DVD, we insert our DVD, and it is tied into the emergency brake so that the car does have to be stopped with the e-brake on to be able to play back our DVD. And to play back or gain control, just touch the screen and we can navigate our menus that are on the DVD with our navigation controls, or we just hit play, pause, track up, down, etc. And then those displays will go ahead and dim out, and now we've got DVD playback. And this is a very, very nice screen. This is an 800 by 480 resolution panel, so it is as tight as any aftermarket Navi out there. Very bright, very tight display, very, very nice. And we do have control from our steering wheel, so we have chapter control just as we'd have if we were touching the menu. Directly from the steering wheel controls itself. Again, if we do want those controls, all we have to do is touch the screen and we get them as an overlay on that display. Now, if we go out to our menu and we hit our rear LCD, we do have the DVD playback available that we can output to our rear screens. So again, we can have a very inexpensive rear monitor that uses the DVD player built into the nav system to power rear entertainment. So you can get out for a quite a bit less than you would normally have to pay for a rear entertainment system because you're relying on the DVD that's actually built into the nav system. And again, that's available at any time the DVD's playing back. So when you go back into your DVD, you have the ability to also mute it, choose your screen resolution or ratio down here, and then hit the video button to bring back up your DVD video display. So very, very nice, very clean, very tight DVD section on the Advent Navi. And then again, we hit the button for eject, and now we're on to our next source, which will be iPod. So once we bring up iPod, you'll notice that we have full steering wheel controls up and down exactly like we would have on the iPod or on the face. We also have all of our data present, so track, artist, album, etc. Our cover art that is available on everything that does have cover art on the iPod. Standard shuffle and repeat functions as well. And then on the search, we have the ability to go out and get our songs, our albums, our artists exactly the same way we do it on an iPod. So if you want to hit albums, we can either page down with our control over here on the right side, or if we hit anywhere in that bar, we have the ability to go all the way down anywhere in that list and choose our song in basically random access, however we want to get there. And again, all the data, all the album artwork, all at a touch of a button. And this is an Apple certified iPod interface, and it is a USB 2.0 interface as well. Now, also from the iPod, you have videos available. I don't have any on this one, but the iPod cable does support video, and you can get that from the iPod as well. The other nice thing is it does also, the interface, let's go ahead and unplug the iPod and plug in our USB stick, and we will have another source that's available at any time a USB stick is plugged in. In this case, we can go to playlist, and you'll see we have a full-blown file browser, just as we would on any any type of a computer type interface. So we have direct access to all the songs that are on the USB stick, and we also have full data, you know, ID3 tagging on your MP3 files with full volume controls, track up, track down, etc. So you really don't even have to have an iPod to be able to carry around thousands of files. You can put them all on a USB stick, plug them into that USB jack, and still have full control over all of the songs that are on the stick. So pretty neat, very, very flexible USB iPod input on the Advent Nav.